giving you an opportunity to get the full story from the people who tell it best. This is MediaCom News Leaders.
Hello, I'm Elizabeth Kling with MediaCom News Leaders. We're talking with Tavita Moa-Lamp right now, the public relations representative for the Coffee and Donut Festival, combining two wonderful things into one great festival. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about what people can expect at the Coffee and Donut Festival.
So you can pretty much expect everything coffee and donuts. We have a couple, or actually a few vendors there. I think there's going to be a donut burger as well, so that's going to be something we kind of go out the on the limb.
This is the second year for this festival, and for people who didn't get to experience the first year, tell us just, like, walk us through what the experience was like.
Oh, man. So it's like the peanut butter and jelly of breakfast, you know what I'm saying? The coffee and donuts. Vendors all over the place. We have different activities for you guys to attend. Last year, I think there was about 2,000 people. We're looking to double our numbers this year and expect 4,000 to 5,000 people.
Wow.
So it's going to be awesome.
It's going to be packed. And this is all taking place then when and where?
It's going to be April 7th at the Seven Flags Event Center in Des Moines.
Okay, and for people who, you know, this is, sounds like a time to just go and indulge, but it sounds like there's really something for everybody, even people who want to be a little health conscious too.
Yeah, we do have some gluten-free options there as well. I mean, you don't have to, you know, act on your sweet tooth.
Yeah.
We have different options as well.
And all kinds of things to try. We want to talk about just a few of the examples. Would you say this is representative of just a little bit of the array that you'll be able to check out?
This is just a little sneak peek of what we got. Different ways to go above and beyond when it comes to a donut. So.
Small, medium, large, you've got it all here. Tell us a little bit about how the pricing works then once people get inside.
Yeah, so after you purchase your ticket and everything, vendors are typically gonna have stuff for sale for about $1 to $5. And you can pay either cash or card at the vendor. So.
Okay. Yeah. And then it's not just eating that will be taking place. There's a lot of activities that will be going on. Tell us about
those. So we do have a bunch of Minute to Win It games for like little kids and stuff. We have sumo wrestling. There is a dodgeball tournament and a bags tournament you actually sign up online for. And there is
a photo opportunity,
Ops.
Yes,
with Mr. Donut. Notorious Mr. Donut. It's our mascot for the Coffee and Donut Festival.
Oh, excellent. So this is something not just adults, kids can get in on.
Everybody.
All ages. Yep. So we want to talk about pricing then. You said once people get inside, then individual vendors will have things for sale. But what are tickets to get in?
Tickets, so it's $30 for VIP access, and the event starts at 8 o'clock. And from 8 to 9, you have access to the whole arena for VIPs. Unlimited donut bar, so you can actually create your own donut for that hour and an unlimited amount of times. And then the $20 general admission, they get access to the donut bar as well. They get one free donut and a free cup of coffee. Also with the general admission, you get $5 towards merchandising, and then the VIP ticket actually gets 10.
Wow.
So, yeah.
All right. So from your experience then last year, tell us a little bit about maybe what was one of the highlights or one of the most memorable donuts for you?
So one of the highlights is actually, so we do a best coffee and best donut of Des Moines. And when Donut Hut found out that they won for their red velvet cake donut, their reaction was pretty awesome. But one thing we're actually bringing new to Des Moines this year is jelly donut wrestling. So it's going to be messy, fun. It's going to be a great time. Bring an extra change, clothes if you want. Otherwise, we'll have some there for you as well.
All right. Well, a lot to look forward to. And again, this is all April 7th. And the website again for people if they'd like more information?
CoffeeDonutFest.com.
All right. Well, Tavita, thanks so much for your time. We appreciate it. We've been talking with Tavita Moa-Lamp, the public relations representative for the Donut and Coffee Festival. Join us next time here on MediaCom News Leaders.